Happy Australia Day to the Aussies, and if you're not, well, I'm very sorry about that. We're celebrating our National Day, the incredible day when an expedition was sent from Britain to settle this great South land. They finally arrived in Sydney 8 months later. What other country started as a prison and did so well? I mean, it's actually very special. But this is just one of the many of my favourite things about Australia. Here are some others. Number one. Australia is the country in the world most affected by white guilt and intergenerational trauma. But somehow, we seem very happy and content. Shows that we are a wonderfully resilient bunch. I mean, all that guilt and dispossession, and yet, what do I feel? Nope. No guilt, nothing. And actually, nobody does really, if they're honest with themselves. Otherwise, they'd leave Australia and go back to where, I probably am not allowed to say that, go back to some other place, perhaps. I think that Jacinta, our favourite Walpiri Anglo-Celtic politician, hit it on the head with this.
Positive impact, absolutely. I mean, now we've got running water, we've got readily available food. I mean, everything that my grandfather had when he was growing up, because he first saw whitefellas in his early adolescence, we now have.
I have talked to Indigenous people, and I'm sure others have too, who talk about generations of trauma among Indigenous Australians as a result of colonisation. But would you accept that there have been generations of trauma as a result of that history?
Well, I guess that would mean that those of us whose ancestors were dispossessed of their own country and brought here in chains as convicts are also suffering from intergenerational trauma. So I should be doubly suffering from intergenerational trauma.
Absolutely wonderful. And Jacinta has a double dose of intergenerational trauma, as she mentioned, but also half a dose of white privilege. What a wonderful country, where we're all so psychologically scarred, but we just keep soldiering on. Number two, Australia has the flag of another country on its flag. And do you know what it symbolises? Extraordinary good luck. I mean, what are the chances we'd end up being settled and colonised by the country that made so many other great countries? Rule of law, definitive land tenure, tolerance, free enterprise, democracy, scientific and industrial advances, decency, cricket. There have been plenty of recent empires. What would things have been like here if our flag was like this? Or this? Or this? Or this. Having that lucky flag in the corner means we're part of a big family called the Commonwealth, and there's nothing wrong with being part of that family. Number three, on the subject of family, did you know that our cousins in New Zealand are actually part of Australia? No, I mean, it's actually written in our constitution. Look at this. The states shall mean such of the colonies of New South Wales, New Zealand, Queensland, Tasmania, Victoria, West Australia, and South Australia. Yep, that's right, Kiwis. You're already the seventh state. Not that it makes any difference because most Kiwis already live in the West Island. Number four, Australia is the only country to have a prime minister just disappear. I mean, he went for a swim with some mates one weekend and that was the end of him. It's pretty cool, actually. Where else does a prime minister just go for a swim with his mates? And they reckon he got caught in a rip, but I reckon he got eaten by one of our unique wildlife, the shark, perhaps. And I mention this because it brings me to the next wonderful thing about Australia. Number five. What other country in the world shoots its national symbol? 3 million of them each year, out of a total of 500 million. Why do I raise this? Well, because it's so much hoo-ha that we've destroyed the Australian environment and it's the end of the world is close. But in reality, our environment is so good, we're outnumbered by kangaroos by 20 to 1. Number six, Australia is just about the only country with enough wildlife left that people are regularly killed by one of the world's 10 most venomous snakes, all of which are Aussies, or people just get plain eaten, especially up here in North Queensland.
In the states far north, you never know what's lurking beneath.
Attacks in the Torres Strait and on the Cape York Peninsula.
Every 3 months, a person is torn to pieces by a crocodile in North Queensland.
I mean, where else has crocodiles and bobcatter? Number seven. What other country requires boxing lessons against kangaroos before they're granted citizenship? That's a shame. The furry bloke with a long tail just failed his citizenship. But it was a good start for the bloke with the cap. If he can pass his English language test and quote Donald Bradman's batting average, 99.93, if you're a real Aussie, comment below, then he will be an Aussie soon enough. And I raise this because sport in Australia, well, we're way ahead of any other country per capita. 6 times better than America, 30 times better than China, 50% better than the second place country. It shows that when we try, we can do all right. Number 8. On this day, we celebrate the incredible patience of the Aboriginal people. I mean, Aboriginals are remarkable for a lot of things, like being able to live in the desert under extreme conditions, but they don't get enough recognition for patience. What other people would wait 60,000 years to finally be liberated from their incredibly difficult lives and be able to have their life expectancies triple and get access to healthcare?
Positive impact, absolutely. I mean, now we've got running water, we've got readily available food. I mean, everything that my grandfather had when he was growing up, because he first saw white fellas in his early adolescence, we now have.
I mean, Moses wandered around in the desert for only 40 years and to reach the promised land, and everybody made a big deal about that. Our remarkable Aboriginal people did it for 60,000 years. Or was it 250,000 years?
A welcome to country is not a ceremony that we've invented to cater for white people. It's a ceremony we've been doing for 250,000 years plus BC, and the BC stands for before Cook.
Number 9, and on the subject of Moses and the Jews, it brings me to the subject of our history in fighting tyranny and all those countries who, let's be frank, well, they owe Australia, or at least Australia of the past. I mean, the First World War, Australia helped bail out the United Kingdom, France, Belgium, Holland, you can argue the whole of Europe. Australia does its bit in the world. And then there's the Second World War, the same, plus Papua New Guinea, the Pacific Islands. And even in the Middle East, I had an Israeli colleague who spoke of his amazement of stumbling on an Australian war cemetery in Israel. Yep, Aussies were crucial in liberating that region from the corrupt Turkish Empire and made the remarkable state of Israel possible, a state which is unique in the Middle East as a liberal democracy, a state surrounded by tyranny. Now, Australia has always punched well above its weight in fighting tyranny. Maybe not so much as the Israelis have, but certainly we've done above our weight. We've done our bit for the rest of the world. Now, there are other countries that are also owed big time by the rest of the world for fighting tyranny, the Americans, the British, the cousins, actually. We're really part of the same remarkable family. For 364 days of a year, it's fine to grumble about this and that in Australia. You might not like the politicians. You might think that having two flags on the coat hanger is one too many. You could well be grumbling about the cost of living or the ridiculously high immigration rate, 1 million people in the last 2 years. But for this one day of the year, smell the roses, or whatever these things are, because we actually live in one of the best countries of the world. Don't grumble, celebrate the reason why those 1 million people wanted to come here, and what a vote of confidence that represents. And finally, for I think the woke mind virus is well and truly dying around the world, laugh at those who take cruel pleasure in accusing this country and our ancestors of crimes for which we are innocent, and for trying to make us feel somehow guilty, because we are not. We can feel lucky about our country, although we can also take some pride that you sometimes make your own luck. And so it is with countries.